Hi. So this lecture is for class 4. Okay. And chapter 1, food and digestion. And this is part 2. So in first part, in first video, we have discussed lot of points regarding what is nutrients, what is fat, what is carbohydrate, and a lot of things we have discussed regarding. So earlier chapter we have discussed about protein, vitamins and all. So now in this video, this is the part 2, we are going to discuss, because the main motto is food and digestion. So what are the things comes in food and what are the things comes in digestion. Now in food, this is important for us, healthy diet. We need to know exactly what is healthy diet. So under healthy diet, we need to define what are the food we take in which are important for us. And we have to divide it in a group 1, group 2, group 3. We have prepared a chart at home for healthy diet in group 1, group 2, group 3. Or in group 1 we can decide whether we go for chapati, roti. Like in group 1 you can go for roti, or you can go for bread. In group 2 you can decide ghee, butter, paneer. In group 3 you can decide as per your convenient pulses, eggs, fish, right, as per your choice. Or in group 4 you can decide vegetables. You can divide in 2 part, leafy and others. So for healthy diet you can prepare a chart at home, or in chart you can decide group 1, group 2, group 3, group 4, where you can decide roti, ghee, butter, paneer, pulses, dal, egg, fish, vegetable. Or as per this chart you can prepare a balanced diet. When you go for Gujarati hotel, you used to find a variety of foods in your plates. Like you are getting 2 vegetables, you are getting curd, you are getting ghee, you are getting paneer vegetables, you are getting green vegetables, you are getting roti, chapati, bread, butter. Lot of things you are getting in a plate. So by this you can understand what is balanced diet. Right? So this is for a healthy diet, you can understand group 1, group 2, group 3. So you can prepare chart by your own, what are the food item you need to have and what are the food item you supposed to eat. If you are vegetarian, you can go for vegetable things. If you are non-veg, you can go for non-veg things. By this, by combination of food, you can prepare a healthy diet. By combination of food, you can prepare diet, that is healthy diet. Now healthy cooking, what mean by healthy cooking? See, 2-3 points are very important for healthy cooking. In healthy cooking, if the food are tasty in healthy cooking, first of all food to be tasty, right? Food to be tasty. Then second, it's supposed to be soft, right? So that it can be easily digestible, right? And third is to be less oily food. so that it can be easily digestible, and you can say less spicy also. So for healthy cooking, we need to understand food to be tasty, soft, and less oily food and less spicy. Now everyone know junk food. Everyone know regarding junk food. What is junk food? We used to always go for what? Farsan. Pizza. Then so many packed namkeen. These are junk food, or we need to avoid, right? We need to avoid. In a month, if you have farsan once, it is okay, but you are not supposed to go for this, because these foods are very harmful. They are taking very, very large time for digestion, right? So farsan, pizza, and packed namkeen, these are very dangerous. Even you can say that bread, we also avoid the bread, right? Bread is also very dangerous. But once upon a time you can have, okay? Now good eating habit for proper digestion. This is very important point. Good eating habit for proper digestion. Good eating habits. So we need to learn good eating habit. Okay? So what are the points for good eating habits? Always take milks in a pleasant environment. Then second, eat at regular interval. Then eat a lot of green vegetable. So I am going to write some point here. Green veg. Okay. Pleasant environment. PLEASCENT. Pleasant pleasant environment means the place where you are eating food, that place should be neat and clean. Go for green vegetable, pleasant environment. Then eat a balanced diet. Balanced diet means you must have roti, rice with green vegetables, then curd, ghee, paneer, etc. Eat fresh and healthy food. Fresh and healthy food means the food which you cook and keep it in a unsafe place, that is not going to become fresh. Once the food is supposed to be ready, you go for food. That food will be healthy for you. So 8 to 10 glass water drink every day. This is the minimum requirement for water, but you can go for 7 glass or 9 glass also, which will help you for digestion. Avoid overeating. avoid overeating. Overeating. Avoid overeating. So sometimes what happen? Our mom used to prepare a good and tasty food. We go for more and more, right? And we used to demand more and more. Like suppose if you go for a party or marriage party or birthday party, there will be a pizza or there will be a farsan or there will be a sweets, right? And we like very much sweet and farsan or pizza or any tasty food. That time we never control on our things. We go for more overeating, which is very dangerous for us. So good eating habit for proper digestion. For proper digestion, what we need to do? Good eating habit. In good eating habit, green vegetable, always we go for green vegetable. We avoid potato. We avoid potato, right? Pleasant environment. When we are eating on a table or anywhere else, the place should be neat and clean. Balanced diet. Balanced diet in the sense you should need to have more and more varieties of food to eat. Fresh and healthy food. You supposed to get a fresh food which will be help you to grow your health, fitness. 8 to 10 glass water drink every day. Sometimes we used to be very lazy in drinking water. This is not good for us. Then avoid overeating. So if food is tasty, please don't go for the same more and more. Chew, the last point is chew. Chew the food. Don't try to get the food in a very fast way. So now the school time is there and you want to, or you want to play, you want to go for play and you are in a hurry and you go for very fast eating food habit. So in this case, you need to chew the food. This is a very important point, right? So first of all, green vegetable, pleasant environment, balanced diet, fresh and healthy food, 8 to 10 glass water, drink every day, avoid overeating, chew the food, right? Now, this is also very important, cooking food, right? By cooking food, cook should be soft, right? And if it is soft, this is easy to digest. Easy to digest. And now this is the last point. Maybe there will be a third part in this chapter, but I am trying to close it. So food preservation. Food preservation is a point where you can preserve the food. And there is two method for preserving. One is freeze. One is freezing. One is freezing and second one is canning, right? So in case of freeze, suppose we are taking any green vegetable or paneer, cheese, milk, etc. we can freeze. Or canning, we are getting so many food product which we can store in our fridge, which will be safe to have food after some time. Okay, so now I will take a tour for some important points. Please go through the same. So this is a group where you can prepare your food chart. This is group 1, group 2, group 3 and group 4. If you prepare this chart, it will be better for you to eat the food, right? And these are the junk food. These are the junk food. And this is the fresh fruit which will be healthy for you, fruit and salad. And this is the junk food. So don't try to go for more and more cakes and pastry and pizza. Okay? So now again I am going to take you a tour of some important points, like see, this is the balanced diet photographs. This is the balanced diet you need to have salad, vegetable, dry fruits, rice, bread, roti, chapati, whatever things. And this is last one is important for you. Pizza and farsan, which you are not supposed to do, you are supposed to eat. This is farsan and pizza. Okay. Now one more is, please be ready to learn this. This is difficult, but you try to prepare a diagram at home, right? This is going to be in a homework. You prepare a diagram and you understand and read carefully what is the function of mouth, liver, then a small intestine, anus, then food pipe from where we are getting food inside our body, and a stomach, then this large intestine. So I will suggest you to go through this and prepare at home and understand it carefully. Okay. Or I am giving you my mobile number. One second, huh? If you are having any doubt, I am giving you my mobile number. Still, if you have any doubt, okay, so you can call me. You can call me in morning 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. Right? My name is Manoj. If you have 9687170756, 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. If you have any doubt again, because this is the chapter 1, food and digestion, part 1 we have already delivered, this is part 2. Chalo, thank you.